Florida Republicans are still moving forward with their attempts to rewrite defamation laws in the state, but their favorite conservative media outlets are telling them, you're going to kill us. You're going to put us out of business. It is virtually... Okay, first of all, this is Andrade. I call him anonymous because most people don't even know who he is. But Andrade here is... that's him. Okay, so he's come up with a bill. Why don't you talk about what the bill is?
Yeah, what this bill would do is it would basically try to rewrite federal law at the state level, which you already can't do anyway, so it should be dead on arrival. But I guess Andrade and his giant forehead doesn't care about that. So what he's done is he's got this legislation that would basically do away with actual malice, which means in order to prove defamation, you no longer have to have that standard of they did it intentionally. So if you go out there and you accidentally say something, you can be sued for it.
Well, a reporter should be able to project about what they believe is happening.
Yeah.
They don't always get it right. Now, that's different from malice. It's different from it's different from the kind of recklessness that the Sullivan case says, look, if you do this, you're going defamation's going to is going to stick even if it's a public figure. But what they've done here is you have what I call it's the gray poupon politicians. That's what he is, gray poupon politicians that say, well, we want to go to, you know, we want to be involved in politics. But when we do something really stupid, like we've seen this Florida legislature do again and again and again, we don't want you to talk about us. And if you talk about us, we want to lower the standard that we can sue you. Now, this guy wants to say, well, we're doing this for the American, we're doing this for the greater good of the Florida public. This is not targeting reporters. This isn't to protect politicians. This is for the greater good of the Florida public. You want to tie that up for me, how this is the greater good for the public?
For the life of me, I can't wrap my head around anything that stupid, but that is the reasoning that these folks are using. But people have to understand, and I know these idiot lawmakers know this, we're not out there talking about Joe Smith on the corner. You know, the average American citizen is not getting slandered by the news media. Who is getting talked about in correct ways are the politicians and the people making the decisions. But what I love about this is that now the conservative media outlets in Florida, and for the record, a lot of them have moved down here, a lot of the big conservative organizations, their talking heads.
Oh, they're all over Florida. They're all over Florida.
And they're now begging these politicians saying, you're going to get me sued. You're going to ruin my career because, they say wild things all the time.
They push the limits. And, you know, by God, they should be able to push limits. It's their right to push limits. It's what we call the First Amendment. As long as they stay within the realm of a New York Times v. Sullivan. Now, I don't know if you know, but I got email, I got text and emails from this guy, from this Andrade, because I did a story one time, call him a man-child, you know, something like that, I don't know. But anyway, he was upset that I wasn't able to analyze New York Times v. Sullivan, as if he was in some special position to do that. So trust me, I can't analyze the case. But he says, well, gee whiz, Clarence Thomas agrees with me, and Gorsuch agrees with me. Therefore, Pap, you're the dummy and you don't understand the First Amendment. I'm reading this, I'm going, what the hell? I wrote back and said, get used to it. Yeah. You know, whatever it is bothering you, kid.
Is he talking about the same Clarence Thomas that was just busted taking yearly luxury trips from a Republican donor and not disclosing? That guy we should be concerned about?
That we shouldn't be able to talk about.
Oh, yeah.
I just got sued now because
I mentioned that story.
All right, well, I'm going to have fun with this as it develops and keep the emails coming because they're just so bizarre. It just makes for a better story. Thanks for joining me, okay?
Thank you.
That's all for this week, but all these segments will be available throughout the next week, and make sure you follow us at Twitter, at America's Lawyer. I'm Mike Papantonio, and this has been America's Lawyer, where we tell you the stories that corporate media won't tell you every week because their advertisers don't let them. They're too tied into the money, or their political connections don't allow for it. They're too Democrat. They're too Republican, so they're afraid to talk about their party. But we're not. We'll see you next time.